In the 1980s, double cassette decks became common, allowing you to easily copy one tape to another or automatically play two tapes in series. And in the 90s, there were dual-deck VCRs, such as this one, which lets you play your 8mm camcorder tapes and copy them to VHS. And then, of course, there were CD changers and DVD changers, which remained popular until the 2000s. You may think that with the shift away from physical media and towards solid-state media, like flash memory and SD cards, that the basic concept of a device with multi-unit playback and recording had become obsolete by the end of the decade. But you'd be wrong, because in 2009, JVC introduced the world's first dual SD card camcorder. It's the GZ-MS120, which was announced by JVC in January 2009, along with one other model also featuring dual SD card slots, the GZ-HM200, which looks virtually identical, except it records in high definition, while this model is only standard definition. JVC said for 2009, what the Averio line offers is choice in storage medium, color, and sharing. The line includes hard disk drive models, memory camcorders, and for the first time, dual memory models, including standard and high-definition dual SD memory card camcorders, the world's first dual card slot models. Both feature a Konica Minolta dynamic optical zoom lens with autofocus and digital image stabilization, a stereo microphone, LED video light, a 2.7-inch flip-out LCD with JVC's unique laser touch system, an upgradable lithium-ion battery pack, and this unique hand strap which can be converted between a hand grip and a wrist strap. As for why someone would choose standard definition when HD was rapidly becoming mainstream by 2009, let's look at the pricing. Yes, that was me testing out this model of camcorder back in 2009 by bringing in my own SD card and putting in one that my local Best Buy store had on display to record some test footage on it. So, Best Buy was selling JVC's standard definition MS120 camcorder for $269. And thanks to another YouTube user doing the same thing, we can see that if you wanted JVC's HM200, which was their entry-level HD camcorder, it would cost you $579. Ouch, that's over twice as expensive. The standard definition model also gives you almost twice the amount of optical zoom, with 35 times instead of only 20 times on the HD model. The dynamic zoom option extends that to 40 times by adding a little bit of digital zoom, but not enough to reduce the image quality, at least according to JVC. It also has superior low-light sensitivity, which was definitely a weakness of many of JVC's entry-level HD camcorders. You could also opt for the GZ-MS130 model, which replaced the second SD card slot with 16GB of internal flash memory. It would cost you $30 extra above the price of the MS120, which also happened to be about the same price as a 16GB SD card in 2009. It still had the space where the second SD card slot would go, but it was blocked off. And for a standard definition camcorder, it has pretty decent image quality. The lens has good optics, the automatic focus and exposure work well, and it reproduces colors accurately. The only real drawback is the digital image stabilization, which is definitely not as effective as optical image stabilization. If you want to see more, I also used it to record my video about this General Electric security light, which I now have in service in my home. It also has the ability to take photos, but they're really just frame grabs from the video, and the maximum resolution is only 640 by 480, so the quality is not very good. It's reminiscent of a Sony Mavica floppy disk camera of the late 90s. As for why JVC decided to introduce the first camcorders with dual SD card slots, it was effectively a stopgap solution for the unexpectedly rapid development of solid-state flash memory storage. Because while the high-capacity SD memory card specification was introduced in 2006, it proved to be rather short-sighted, because it only took 2 years for its capacity limit to be reached when the first 32GB SDHC cards were introduced in 2008. That limit was alleviated with the introduction of the SDXC specification in 2009, which increased the limit to 2TB, but the first devices which supported SDXC cards were not introduced until 2010. So, that left a 2-year period in which the only way to expand a device's storage capacity beyond the 32GB limit of an SDHC card was to add another SDHC card slot. Plus, it allowed for the trick feature of continuous recording. During recording, when one storage medium fills up, recording automatically switches to the other. When recording with the dual-slot GZ-MS120 in the highest quality mode, recording capacity ranges from 3.7 hours using a pair of 8GB cards to 15 hours using two 32GB cards. But there's an important caveat when it comes to the ability to automatically switch between the SD cards while recording. As the manual says, the switching time of the SD cards requires approximately 3 seconds. If there are many videos and data in the SD card, it may take up to a few minutes to perform the switch. No video is recorded during that time. And after recording video for 12 consecutive hours, recording stops automatically, so you cannot make an infinitely long recording by continuing to hot swap SD cards back and forth between the slots. So to test the ability of it to automatically switch SD cards while recording, in slot A I have a 4GB card, which is about 3/4 full. And slot B, I have a 2GB card, which is empty, and I have this aftermarket extra capacity battery pack. And it's telling me, in slot A, it'll be able to record 21 minutes of video, and slot B, it'll be able to record 28 minutes of video, and the battery claims to have 460 minutes of capacity remaining. So it should run out of SD card space long before the battery goes dead. And I'll leave it recording the image of a clock, so that way we can see exactly how much of a gap there is in the recording when it switches between the SD cards. So here it is after it's done. Slot A is completely full. Slot B is completely full. And the battery still has 390 minutes remaining. According to the timestamps of the files, it looks like the video on the card in slot A stopped recording at 8:46 and 38 seconds, and the video on the card in slot B began recording at 8:46 and 46 seconds, which is an 8-second gap. But let's look at the footage to verify that. That turned out to be about a 9.5-second gap in the footage, which isn't great, but still better than the amount of time it would take you to manually swap SD cards, especially if you weren't paying close attention while recording and didn't notice the exact moment the first card had filled up and stopped recording, and then made even worse on a camcorder like this Canon, where the card slot is on the bottom, requiring you to unmount it from a tripod to change the SD card. JVC manufactured two additional models of camcorders with dual card slots. In 2010, they had the GZ-HM300 with dual SDHC card slots. And by the way, even though it says 1080p output, this actually records in 1080i interlaced, just like the HM200 that I mentioned earlier. And one new feature it advertises is seamless recording, so there should no longer be a gap in the footage when it switches between the card slots. But one very unfortunate thing is that JVC decontented the built-in LED video light on their entry-level HD camcorders in 2010. Their standard definition models still had it, but on their HD models, you just got a plastic knockout plug where that LED video light would go. And Sony did the same thing. For example, this standard definition Sony Handycam from 2011 has a built-in LED video light, but on their comparable HD model, which is based on the same camcorder body, all you got was a Sony logo where the video light would go. And speaking of 2011, that was the final year that JVC had a camcorder with dual card slots, the GZ-HM440, this time with dual SDXC card slots, but it still only records in 1080i, again despite claiming 1080p output through the HDMI port, and again, no built-in LED video light. But one very unfortunate thing with those two final models is that they moved the card slots to the bottom of the camcorder, requiring you to take it off of a tripod in order to insert or remove a card, which I find to be much less convenient. So that's about it for these JVC camcorders with dual SD card slots, an oddity that only had very brief relevance in the late 2000s and early 2010s. Unlike double cassette decks, which stuck around for decades.